the key difficulties when it comes to research is understanding the very complex terminology involved, such as the research position the researcher takes. And this is normally summarized by these three complex terminologies: ontology, epistemology, and axiology. Ontology is the nature of knowledge, epistemology is how we know what we know, and axiology is the value we give to that knowledge. So here's a little illustration of how we can kind of get our heads around these concepts. The first one is from a movie called The Gods Must Be Crazy. In this movie, a guy flies over a bushman in the Kalahari, and he drops a Coke bottle out of the window. The bushmen have never seen a bottle before, ever. So when this bottle lands, they're not quite sure what the use of the bottle is. And so they use it to dry out skin, they use it to bash vegetables, etc., etc. Now, as a Westerner, if I came across them and saw how they were using the bottle, I might explain to them how it should be used. But the fact that they are not aware of what this is how we can describe ontology. How do we validate knowledge in terms of it being real and accurate? So if I met somebody at a bus stop and they told me about the fairies at the bottom of the garden, whether I believed that those fairies were real or not is ontology. And how I believed that knowledge is valid or true is my epistemology. What do I base that on? And then what value do I give it in terms of knowledge, which is axiology. So as a positivist or somebody who is scientific in knowledge, knowledge is only valid and reliable if it's scientifically based. I know this through testing, validity testing, credibility in those testings, and therefore the value I give to the final data. But as an interviewee, interpretivist position, I'm not really worried about whether their experience is valid or not. I'm interested in their experience. What does it mean to believe in those fairies? Does it give them hope? And I want to explore those elements. So again, the researcher is influenced by their ontology, how they understand the nature of knowledge, how they know what they know, epistemology, and therefore the value they give to that knowledge, which is axiology. So if you take a more objective route towards your research, you would be, in the extreme case, representative of what we would call scientific research. So picture, for example, some experiments taking place in a lab. You're following a very strict list of what needs to be done. You're doing it in a particular order. And you, the research instrument, should not be influencing anything that is taking place in terms of the actual experiment. In other words, if I stepped out of the room and somebody took over, like my daughter, and she followed the instructions exactly as they put out in the way that you should be doing it, it should make no difference. That's the objectivity of the research. However, if I was doing an interview and I'm sitting in front of the interviewee and I dipped out of the room and somebody else took over for me, clearly that does make a huge difference as the research instrument. This is subjective research. Now, normally, the way that this works, because of the research positioning, the research philosophy, objective researchers would not really be interested in subjective research because it's too subjective. There's too many emotions involved. There's too many parameters that are out of control. And interpretivists or subjective researchers are not potentially interested in objectivity because everything is just a number. They're interested in the person sitting in front of them in terms of the emotions, in terms of experience and in-depth understanding of that person's experience as a phenomena. And these two opposing positions, the objectivity and the subjectivity, are key in understanding research design. And it's underpinned, it's the foundation of this, is ontology, epistemology, and axiology.